last one, right? You're driving it the other way. Okay, that's the same ball over there that you were hitting off the end of the bat. Right? Yeah. Hands going out to the ball. Sequence, you lose your connection early. You know what that is?
Yes. When you I guess when you start doing something wrong, then like everything just goes wrong.
But you lose. Okay, but you know what your connection is?
Yes.
Elbow. Okay. Take a swing. That's the pull ball. Backhand will stop the whole play. It stops early. Start with your shoulders first. Your hips don't fully rotate. Okay, so you end up with the connection early. Cause you to be early to roll over. Let your left eye go left. Fully rotate. Okay. Don't break your ankle doing that. There you go. Good. Remember, you gotta let your big muscles do the work. Let the big muscles do all the work. Inside the front. Go back. is sitting on top of your back leg, it's going to throw your head back. And your head has to stay over your spine just a little. The whole time. Go back, stay over your spine, not on top of your back leg.
Not too far back.
Muscles are doing the work.
So what it look like doing the work? When you say that, so what muscle does it look like it doing the work?
Using the shoulder.
Okay. All right. So you top down, going top down versus the ground.
Yeah, like
spiral from the ground up.
Or whip or whatever.
Yeah.
He's doing this first before this even moves.
Mm-hmm.
So it's out of sequence.
Right.
So he's using a small muscle to do that.
Okay.
So what happens is, so because he can't generate the same amount of bat speed when he does that, in his brain, he tries to do it like extra.
Mm-hmm.
So he ends up doing that. So he generates the same amount of bat speed that his legs produce, and he can't do it.
Right.
So you know. Yeah. Compensate.
Yeah, overcompensating. Yeah, yeah, I guess.
Yeah, trying to compensate, trying to make up for that bass speed, lack of bass speed, right? Versus use your legs, you're using the combination of all this,
right?
Which is way, way stronger than just your arms.
Uh-huh.
Right? So you don't even have to give 100% effort, and you still create a lot more bass speed.
Gotcha.
So that's what he's doing. So because he was telling me that he's out in front of everything.
Yeah.
And that's because, and that's the reason. He's got a sequence. So he's up there. Hands out, and he's got to pull the head back, get the barrel back to the ball, all that stuff. And it's all started by him being out of sequence. So if you're watching him, you probably got it on film already. But when he took his first few swings, right, his back hip stopped at the catcher. Done with the swing before his hips got a chance to run to it. So again, that's an indication of what we're being out of sequence. So this is going first, and so it stops right there.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're swinging, your hips have to stop at some point.
Right.
For that to go. Usually you want it to stop at home plate. Hips stop and your hands end up passing your hips. That's what generates the bat speed. Out of sequence, stop running. Kind of stumble back at the end a little bit. Yeah, it's only a little, right? That's caused by your head jerking up. Okay, so you have to stay in your posture the whole time. Don't jerk your head up. Go back. started to swing, your head went back. So when your head goes back, the barrel of the bat follows your head. Right? So you end up hitting the top of the ball and rolling your hand over early.